this is Python Pop, a series of quick videos explaining different Python functions and commands. And in today's video, we're going to go over how to make a simple histogram. And we're going to be using pyplot. So let's go ahead and import that first. So we're going to start by importing the matplotlib. So import matplotlib.pyplot. And we're going to import that as plotplt. Now, before we even get going with the histogram, we need some simple data. So let's assume that a teacher asked the class of, let's say, 20 students what their favorite numbers were between 0 and 9. So I'm going to say for I in the range of 20, since I said there were 20 students, we're going to populate some list. And let's call this list favNum for favorite numbers. So favNum. Let's create it empty before our for loop, and then we're going to populate it now. So we're going to say favNum.append a random integer, random.randint, and it's between 0 and 9. So 0, 9. And after this, just so I can see what my favorite number list is, I'm going to print out favNum. And don't forget, we have to import random. So there we have it. There's our list of numbers. See that 0 and 9 are indeed inclusive because we have zeros and 9 throughout. Now we're ready to plot that histogram of the favorite numbers of the class. So a histogram returns the values of the histogram bins, which is going to be n. It returns the edges of the bins, which we'll call bins, and it also returns a container of individual artists used to create the histogram or list, which we'll call patches. And now we're going to say plot.hist, and our input is our favNum, and let's go ahead and run this. So there we go, we can see our favorite numbers. Now the default bin size is 10. It defines the number of equal width bins in some range. And it's a little hard to actually see the edges in this histogram. So we're going to change the edge color, EC, and let's make it black. So now we can individually see the different bars. Now note this doesn't exactly line up. See how it's slightly off for the 8, and then over here, the 6 is centered, whereas the 0 is to the left. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually input a range that I want the bins to be at. And that range is going to be from 0 to 10. So as opposed to using the default bins, I'm going to make my own. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Those are the different numbers for our bins. And I'll want to go all the way up to 10 because that last number in the list is not included in the bin. So 10 won't be included, and it'll start at 9. That'll be one bin. Starting at 0 is another bin. Starting at 1 is a bin, and so on and so forth. So when I run this, there we have it. My bins are now aligned and are easier to comprehend. Notice that between 8 and 9, I have nothing, because there was not 8 chosen as a favorite number. And if I want to shift this to be centered over the number, I'm going to change align and set it to left. That's going to shift all my bars in the histogram to the left. Now you can see we're centered over those whole numbers. And it's quite easy to see which number occurred the most. That was 3 in our random list. Now yours may look slightly different than mine, but feel free just to type these numbers into the favNum list so that you get the same exact looking histogram. And that wraps up this video. As always, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share.